Welcome back to the second installment of figuring out which grouping of Pokemon products has the best pulls. We just did, in the last video, three booster packs. Now we're going to look at the luxury ball and see what's in here. Now this is going to be different from the booster packs. I had booster packs that were all of the Sword and Shield newest set. Traditionally, with these kind of tin products, they come with different packs inside than what is the most current set. So, we're going to have a little bit of a mystery here with the luxury ball to see what is inside of it. It probably won't be the newest set. Let's see what we get for this. An Evolutions. Okay, this is an XY set, which is not even the previous generation. It's the one before that. So this is EX cards that we might see in here. Here's base set Sun and Moon, which is going to be the GX cards, and then Sun and Moon Guardians Rising. So we have some GX possibilities, some EX possibilities. I'll remind you when I clean this up here that the scoring system that I use to see what is good pulls for these, the reverse holo rare is worth 1 point. A holographic card is worth 2 points. A GX, EX, V standard is worth 3 points. If we get a special version of that, it's 5. If we get a rainbow rare, 6. So 3 to the front for the XY sets. And here's what we have. These are cool classic. This is like a reprint of the first Pokemon basic set, so it has a lot of nostalgia, but there are really big swings and misses with this set that if you don't pull the exact right cards, you're not going to find a whole lot of value, but it's still really cool to see these. And like we just got here, a Starmie, regular rare, nothing special. There's about, I don't know, there's a whole lot of those that just don't live up to what you're hoping for. I've seen that Starmie used in maybe 2 or 3 decks. So not the best. But here we go. We have a base set, Sun and Moon. So this is the previous generation, Generation 7. We're on Generation 8 now. But we'll see if we can get anything here. Wishy-washy. Got Alolan Persian, Zubat, a lot of interesting cards coming through. Okay, so here we go. Here's the Gigalith reverse. Let's see if we can get, and he's a rare, so that's 1 point. That's great. And nope, nothing special. So we have 1 point so far from our grouping. Here's our last chance. We need to pull something good here if this set wants to compete with the 5 points that we got from our booster packs earlier. So we'll do 4 to the front. That puts the rare on the back here. So it's the last thing that we see. Got an energy, field blower. That's a playable card, very useful for expanded. Choice band, slowpoke, stuffle, Mudbray. Not a rare, so no points here. And not a holographic either. So really, for these three packs, in terms of how we're scoring this, we got 1 point with the Gigalith reverse holo rare. So the luxury ball, as cool as it looks, really didn't give us a whole lot in the way of pulls. It's cool to display. It's fun to open the packs. But in reality, we got a few cards that might be playable, maybe some trainers that are valuable for the game itself. But in terms of pulls, 1 point for us. Like the video, subscribe to Kiki Collecting, and we will see you next time to check out these other two options. Have a good day.